members of the graduating class of 2019. For many, it has been a long 4 years, but here you are, ready to graduate. Again, I've heard you louder in the hallways. Let's give another round of applause for this year. It's more like class of 2019. You worked hard to get to this point, but you didn't do it by yourselves. You owe a huge debt of gratitude to the following people. I am fortunate to work with the dedicated staff of educators who support you day in and out. To your teachers who give unselfishly, sharing their time, talent, and knowledge with you, I want to give a special thanks to Mr. Wake, who has served as your class advisor for the previous class 2 years. And a special thank you to teachers, counselors, paraprofessionals, tutors, mentors, everyone that has helped you through these 4 years. To your families, friends, mentors, thank you for supporting our graduates in more ways than is possible. You dragged them out of bed in the morning, you fed them, clothed them, pushed them out the door, off to school. You asked about their homework, you supported extracurricular activities, and you gave them a push when needed. Thank you. Please give your families, your friends, what the future will hold. It's not a distant reality. Not a distant reality. Reality anymore. It begins here. It begins today. You began high school 4 years ago as young teenagers. I'm a little scared, hesitant, but tonight you're leaving as young adults ready to turn to the world. The education that you received at the High School Commerce has prepared you to go on to college, a selective career, or for some, you may be enlisting in the military. Each of you will travel your own path, no matter where you go or what you do. You will have challenges ahead of you, whether it's the first day of moving into a new college campus and meeting new friends, starting on a career path in a highly competitive position, or your first week, etc. What I'm sure of is that each of you will meet those challenges straight on, with your head held high, and with grit. It's not simply enough to try to get by in life. That doesn't move you forward. You must try to excel in everything you do. Strive for excellence in every task, large or small. Somebody once said individual success benefits society as a whole, because when you succeed, you lighten the burden on your fellow man or woman. When you succeed, you are in a position to give rather than to take. Imagine if every individual lived up to his own potential. Think about how amazing the world would be. Even if half of us lived up to the potential, the world would still be pretty amazing. While you may not have the power to inspire the world to strive for success, but you do have the power to try to achieve for yourself. My challenge to each of you is to do all you can to reach your full potential. If each of the 177 students in this graduating class is able to do that, just imagine the effect we would have on our community, our country, our world. The future is truly in your hands, so make the most of it. At this time, I would like to say it's a pleasure to have the Honorable Mayor Sarno from 1984 graduate of the High School Commerce to address our class.
Superintendent Dan Warwick, school committee members Martha Gresham, Denise Hurst, Tony Naylor, Principal Bauer, distinguished guests on stage, the fantastic chorus, fantastic band. Let's give them a big round of applause. Class of 2019, how does it feel? I hear from family and friends and the graduates. This graduation of the high school promise was always very near and dear to my heart, because I stand before you as a proud graduate of the high school of Commerce, class of 1981. I say that to you because I have the honor and privilege of being your mayor, and you too can do the same, if not better. Now this journey has been filled with trials and tribulations, but you've shown perseverance, fortitude. But beside you in this journey has been your family, your mom, your dad, your extended family, who put a roof over your head, clothes on your back, and food on the table. And they're always there, like all of our parents, to give us a little gentle opening behind in a respectful way, but they stood with you through the trials and tribulations and the triumphs. Now is the important time. Take a look around. Let's give them a big round of applause. Thank you, parents and family, for your continued belief and investment in our city of Springfield. You have a second family, and that's the teachers and administration staff of the high school departments. Sometimes they might get in your face and push you a little bit, but they do that because, like your family, they love you and they care about you and they know that you can and will succeed. Now's the time to give them a look around and give them a round of applause. Now your foundation's been laid at home. Your skills have been honed at the High School of Commerce. Some of you are going to move on to college. Some of you will move on to technical institutions. Some of you will move on to the workforce. And some of you will move on to military service. And Godspeed to each and every one of you that serve in our military. And to all our
you had somebody come through our door and help you along.
And so I did behind the scenes, solving problems of making for a better community. So to each and every one of you, I am so proud of you. And don't let anyone tell you that you cannot achieve and reach your dreams. Congratulations to the class of 2019.
Our armed forces are beginning their careers. You're just getting started. And make a difference and think big. In closing, remember, you are the best and the greatest part of the High School of Commerce. Once again, congratulations, best wishes.
Thank you, school committee, Ms. Rusher. At this time, I'd like to invite the High School of Commerce Jazz Band to play Earth, Wind, and Fire Dance Mix. Thank you. Broken Rim, which he wrote in the student faculty basketball game on Friday. Our first student speaker tonight is student representative Alexia Richardson.
I got
many people grow by hearing here on this day. Remember that we are strong, brilliant, determined. Let us not forget the lives of our brethren. Failure is not a sign of defeat, but push to greater opportunities. Because the journey is a never-ending road of our life's dreams to opportunity. Because the journey continues, this is only beginning. And I would like to say congratulations to class of 2019.
The value of forgiveness, the importance of being generous,
We have to look at ourselves and see if we're present ourselves as the Lord to break our Jesus. And at this one point, they spoke to the group of me at every graduation, by the way, I'm saying to them, where you come from is not about where you stay. Do not be afraid to experience life outside of World War III, because distance doesn't tear your ties. Do not stay in comfort and scare yourself sometimes. Do better what you have learned better. Do more, do yourself. And do all these things while displaying respect for yourself and respect for your people. As we pass into the next chapter of our lives, I offer the words of two men who have faced the world who it is. As American journalists, Joe Lydia and Walker Isaac come on self-respect. People with self-respect have the courage of their mistakes. They know the price of things. People with self-respect exhibit a certain toughness, a kind of honor, that are willing to accept responsibility for what's in life. And in the wise words of American poet and civil rights activist, Maya Angelou, you may encounter many defeats, but you must not be defeated. In fact, it may be necessary to encounter the defeats, so you can know who you are, what you can rise from, and how you can still come out of them. I am Tori Wolf. Continue to learn. Teach others what you have been taught. Drop torches of knowledge on the paths that lead to others. As my journey continues, it will bring me great joy to touch the hearts and minds of others the way this world should. Thank you.
The next student is an extraordinary individual who exhibits remarkable strength in mathematics, physics, and IT. He is held in high regard by both his peers and teachers. In his letter of recommendation by his physics teacher, Mr. Burke, he wrote, "Kenny's ingenuity and determination shine bright during project-based learning activities. What impresses me most about Mr. Tai during his assignments is that he always chose a designer path that challenged him. He never took the path of least resistance. He took time to be thoughtful, plan his design, made revisions when necessary, budget appropriately, put forth his best possible finished product. I recall times when the final product met the goal, as well as times it did not. Regardless of the final outcome, he took time to reflect upon his work, noting what went well, what did not, or what he might have done. These academic traits and habits indicate that Mr. Tai is incredibly close to the field of engineering and will excel in any of its abilities. Kenny participated in the Upward Bound program to support him. With their support, he applied to and was accepted to 8 different universities. He created and managed the Founders Esports Club. He has worked as an IT intern for his 4 years, including summers where he taught other students and provided technical support for both hardware and software needs for the high school program. This year, he was the editor of the Founders Yearbook and worked as a teaching assistant for Mr. Burke's intro to physics classes. He is taking 11 honors classes and 7 international library classes at the high school Founders. He participated in 2 dual enrollment classes in programming and computer basics at Springfield Technical Community College. Despite the strong interest in technology, Kenny has chosen a different path. Kenny will attend the Culinary Institute
have been certified as having met all of the graduation requirements. By the powers vested in me by the Springfield School Committee and the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, I hereby declare the class of 2019 to be graduates of the high school. And your task is for the right to Armani Carter.
Kevin Baez.
Kiara Delis Alvarez. Thais Marie Lombardo. Annabel Padilla. Marianne Raphael. Danford Raphael. Tian Trinh. Thank you.
Vargas Betancourt. Ashley Palomares.
Thank you. Giorgio.